This is massive when it comes to the new features that were announced from Procreate. And in terms of using this, I don't think a lot of users are going to know about it or know they need to turn this on. The Procreate on the iPad is fantastic. There is no denying that. But there are a few little bugs or quirks or problems that I want to highlight today. And we're going to talk about two very specifically because they could change the way you use this app, or you might not even be able to use them yet. Now, keep in mind, Procreate is the best app out there when it comes to digital art content on the iPad. You can never change my mind about that. This is not about ripping on Procreate. This is about how you may not be able to use some of the features you've heard so much about, or how some of those little features work. Well, let's jump in and have a look at what they are, starting with the new barrel roll features. So if you have the new iPad and Apple Pencil, you probably have heard about the new barrel roll feature specifically within Procreate. Now we're gonna have a talk about this today because it is fantastic, but there are definitely some things you have to know before you can jump in and use this on Procreate. So to show you exactly what I mean about barrel roll inside Procreate, I've got the new iPad, the new Apple Pencil here. If I open up my brush library, you can see that I've gone to the abstract section here, or the abstract folder, and I've chosen Triangulum. This is going to be a really good brush to show you, or better yet, the little caveat I've found to actually using this within some Procreate. Let's minimize this. I've got this nice pink magenta color chosen, and I'm just going to take my Apple Pencil and move it around the screen. I'm going to try and use that barrel roll, but as you can see, nothing is happening yet. This brush is not barrel rolling. Now that's not ideal. Now something you need to know, and the reason this made it into today's video, that barrel roll is not automatically turned on with your brushes inside of Procreate. Let's two finger tap on the screen, undo that. I'm going to show you how to turn it on, and you are going to have to do this for each and every brush with inside Procreate. We're going to tap back on our brush library here. We're going to find the brush we want. Again, Triangulum. We're going to tap on that brush. And then we have our options down on the left-hand side of the screen here, and we want to have a look for shape. Now, this is exactly where we need to be. Now, what you're specifically going to be looking for is this center panel here, shape source. At the moment, it's set to touch only. Most of your brushes are going to be set to this. That's fine. But you notice here too below that, it's azimuth and barrel roll. We're going to go ahead and tap that to on, make sure it's selected. And then once I move this brush around the screen and I start to tilt the Apple Pencil, you notice that I'm getting that barrel roll effect. Perfect. We're going to get done on the top right of the screen, minimize our brush library. And then when I draw with this brush, you're going to see that when I tilt or roll the Apple Pencil, my brush is now reacting to that and giving me barrel roll. Nothing too major here, but please keep this in mind. Even if you've got barrel roll turned on in the Apple Pencil settings within your iPad, you will have to turn it on individually for each and every brush if you want to use it inside of Procreate. But trust me, get out there, give this one a go. It is so much fun to use and you never know what you can create. Moving straight onto the second bug or problem I want to highlight so far when it comes to Procreate on the new iPad is the fact that we don't have the new tool palette option when it comes to squeezing your Apple Pencil. We don't get that in Procreate yet. That is coming in a future update, but it is something personally that I found when I bought this iPad and Apple Pencil that I was so excited to use straight away. And unfortunately, it's not something you're going to get straight out of the box if you are buying it currently or have bought it since this release. Personally, I found this really disappointing. No shade at anyone, I'm sure it's going to take quite a bit to figure out. And I have tried absolutely every option on the iPad when it comes to getting this to turn on. But unfortunately, it's not in Procreate yet. Not a massive deal, but one of the reasons why I did upgrade, and I cannot wait to use it. So please keep that in mind. But it does come to that tool palette and wanting to come up when you do squeeze the Apple Pencil here. If we do go into our settings and go to Apple Pencil here, we do see that we have it selected here, tool palette, but unfortunately it's not talking to Procreate yet. But I would encourage you to jump in and have a look at these other options here when it comes to what you want it to select. So if you do have it set to tool palette like I do at the moment, even though you're not going to get the new and improved one, if I squeeze it inside of Procreate, I do get the option to have my old quick menu appear here. That can be really useful, or I could go back to the settings and have it pick one of these other things here as well. There are a few workarounds there, so please don't give up on it yet. It is fantastic. I will always be using Procreate. I think it's the absolute best app out there. And hopefully moving forward, we get the update we want very soon. In conclusion, this is definitely not a game changer by any means. I just want you to know about it, because if you're using this app as much as I do, I know that I wish I was told about these a little bit earlier as well. Please let me know in the comments below if you've had some of the same frustrations I've had, if you've been looking forward to this feature, if maybe the reason you upgraded was these features, or you just want to have a chat about digital art in general. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel because it does help me bring you these videos each and every week. So until the next video, I'll catch you then.